First of all, Cybernetics is a certification body and an ISO 17025 compliant laboratory. We are not a review site. So we don't care about views. The YouTube channel we have is just to post some interesting videos like this stuff. All equipment we use is fully calibrated and we know exactly how to use the equipment. This is not me telling that some other guys did it wrong. No, I just want to get down to the facts, to see what will happen. We do this video because there are some videos online. Actually, one from a huge Brazilian YouTube channel, site, Adrenaline. They tested a 5090 with the same power supply. I think it was an SFX-L Corsair 1000. And they showed some photos of the microfit connectors on the PSU side, which were melted. So, we want to do this video to see if indeed the connectors melt. So guys, we have a Corsair SFX-L unit, 850. We don't care about the capacity. We do care about the connectors. It has the microfit connectors, two of them, two 8-pin microfit connectors, to a single 12-volt 2x6. So we're gonna fully load the power supply into a hot box. The ambient temperature inside the box will be around 40 degrees Celsius. And we monitor here the ambient and the temperatures of the connectors, which go into the PSU, on the PSU's modular panel. And we're gonna see if we will have any melting conditions, melting connectors. In the 5090, on a real card, it is very tough to have sustained 600 watt load, all the time 600 watt. There will be some deviations on the load. But the maximum load will be 600 watt, okay? Here, we will continuously have 600 watt. So it will be much worse. And we will also increase the temperature because SFXL units are usually installed in a small chassis where there is no airflow. And it is very tough to keep the temperatures under control. Imagine if you have the PSU's modular panel at 40 degrees Celsius, 45, and you pass 600 watt through two tiny microfit connectors, yeah, there can be issues. And this is what we will see now here. But again, we will apply the worst possible conditions. 600 watt continuously. I even spoke to Corsair and they told me that under extreme conditions, since we are talking about SFX-L unit here, if it is into a very small chassis with minimal airflow, all things can go wrong. You never know. It's 600 watt, guys. 600 watt or 50 amps. It's not a low load. We're heating up now inside. Around 50 amps, degrees. 50 amps. Let's make it, because I have some voltage drop, 600 watt, okay? 600 watt, 51.3 amps.
What's here, the temperature?
So, ambient starts to drop. George, we more. Need ambient, more, give it.
More.
This is the temperature on the connectors, on the PSU side, okay? It's very low so far, but the ambient is also low. We need to give it some time, guys, for the hot box environment to get hot from the PSU. it's already 30 degrees Celsius. It's not low, but I expect a higher temperature inside the small chassis. Normally, you will never have 600 watt all the time continuously. Even if you run the GPU at full load, there will be some very, very small periods where the load drops from 600 watt. It will go 550, 540, 530, even if you run firmware. Now, we have constant load, 600 watt or 51.4 amps. This is the worst case scenario, guys. And I want to see, I will leave it here for 30 minutes, and I want to see if the connectors will melt. Actually, since we don't have that much time, let's go 55 amps. 55 amps is 640 now. 55 amps. That's above the limit, Eri. This is the ambient. We don't care so much about that. We do care about that. But yeah, we also need the ambient. You see, it starts to rise. So we are around 15 minutes time. The highest temperature in the connector is 38.3 degrees Celsius. Mm-hmm. 55 amps load, 640. Let's go 660. No, let's keep it 55. It's not hot. 55 amps. Mm-hmm. 35 degrees Celsius. And again, a single cable takes all that load. Only the 12-volt 2x6 cable is connected to the fixture. Nothing else. IR cameras, you have to set the emissivity, guys, okay? If you don't set the emissivity correctly, they are not accurate. Low battery, low batar. I don't see anything alarming. How much time we're running the load? 18 minutes already. 57. Amps, 662 watt, almost. I will leave it for half an hour. Half an hour at 57 amps and 662 watt. And ambient already 36 degrees Celsius. The ambient starts to go higher. Now, if you have a chassis with 50 degrees Celsius ambient, then you're doing something wrong. What I suspect that happened, to have a melted connector on the GPU side, yes, I can understand that, because there's already the modular connection with the PSU in line. You have the hot air coming out of the GPU, although I noticed that even that it's hot there, it still helps cool down the connector. The thing is that you have to make a very, very tight connection. In the GPU, I tried yesterday some of the new cables that we have made with included protections. If you don't have the connector all the way in, guys, you get a red light from the GPU, and the GPU doesn't operate normally. This is not the case, though, for the power supply. If it is not the connector fully into the PSU, it will still work. And under high loads, you can have melted connectors. So you have to be careful that the connectors are all the way inside the modular panel, inside the PSU's modular panel header, okay? So I suspect that the problem is there. The connection with the PSU's modular panel wasn't good enough. It might look that it's okay, but you have to hear the click. You have to make sure that there is no even a millimeter difference between the connector and the header. Okay. So we're close to 40 degrees Celsius now, way higher the load than the normal that you will see inside the real system. We're well above 600 watt, 661.5 watt, and 57 amps, because the amps are what makes the difference. So guys, we're gonna end the test after 31 minutes of continuous load, 661.62 watt and 57 amps, ambient 38 degrees Celsius, and the temperatures on the connectors are actually very low here. And we're gonna show you now the connectors on the PSU side. Thank you. if the cable was too hot, I wouldn't be able to touch it like that. Okay. No, perfect. Cables are perfect. Minutes, 57 amps, 660 watt of load, 38 degrees Celsius ambient, yeah. Nothing. I don't know why there are problems. As I told you, you have to make sure that it goes all the way in. All the way in, like that. Okay. All the way in. You have to make sure. Even a millimeter away can melt the connector. Okay. So make sure it's all the way in.